Well, it's Wednesday. Here's your favourite. Here he is, Kel Richards. You are my audience's favourite, Kel. I get so many emails. We'll get into it, though. Rhetorical. Roger wants to know the difference between supporting Hamas and supporting Hamas rhetorically.
He's not alone. We've had lots and lots of emails from Credlin viewers saying, what is going on here? OK, rhetorical. Rhetorical is an old word, came into English around 1300 from a Latin source, and it just means speaking out loud, especially speaking persuasively, but speaking out loud. So rhetorically supporting Hamas means someone saying out loud, I support the terrorist organisation Hamas. Now, according to Mike Burgess Amazio, if you say that, you get a visa and you get to come in. That's what we don't understand. Now, he may now be regretting using that word rhetorical when he was talking on television, or this is just Kel being a bit cynical, or he dropped it deliberately so that we would know how he was being briefed by the Albanese government. He's saying, you can put your hand up and say, I support a terrorist organisation, we wave you through. And Australians are saying, what do you need to do to be refused a visa? Do you need to be carrying a gun when you say it? Is that the only way to be refused a visa?
It's terrible. It is absolutely terrible. Oh. I think Australians, this is cut through like nothing else. Hey, this is another one. John wants to know about a word that was one of my dad's favourite words. And if it was thrown at you, there couldn't have been a worse insult as a kid. It's the word sook. Now, it gets used in the parliament, and he wants to know, where does the word sook come from?
It's been ruled unparliamentary language, I believe. It means a crybaby or a coward. It's Australian slang recorded from 1910. But although it's Australian, it comes from a Scottish source word. But there were lots of Scottish settlers in Australia, so that sort of makes sense. The suggestion behind the word is that a weakling is like a baby who is being breastfed. That means a baby who is called a suck, and in the Scottish dialect pronounced sook. So that's where it comes from. A weakling, a little baby.
What about a fancy ball, a fancy dance? Ralph wants to know, why do we call it a ball?
Okay, two words. Spherical object, ball, having a dance ball, totally different words. They're called homonyms because they look the same, sound the same, but they come from different sources, different meanings. The spherical object comes from a Germanic word. The dance comes from a French word, but they are just accidentally identical.
There you go. Kel, thank you. See you next week.